So Jump Festa was literally around the corner not long ago, and we had some good, interesting announcements in regarding to the Bleach anime, as well as many other projects across the board. And people weren't really somewhat happy with it when I live streamed the event and people saw that it was a rock musical. So what we're going to be doing in today's video is addressing that discussion, as well as many other things about Bleach in the future as a whole leading up to 2024. So if you want to get up to date with more news related stuff and anything in regards to me or Bleach in general, hit that like and subscribe, and let's just jump into it, shall we? Jump Festa happened, we had the trailer, which was really fucking cool, and I want to elaborate further on that it is in fact a teaser trailer, because a trailer would be one with an opening in it and it would show a lot more, where we got about maybe 2 or 3 episodes within this teaser as a whole, and we got to see Ruruka. It was amazing. You saw my reaction, and of course I made a few blunders here and there within the reaction itself, thinking that there was going to be new content, but you know, again, colored manga and anime are going to look different, so that's why it confused me a little bit. But regardless of what, thank you to those in the comments that reminded me or corrected me on some of those things. Overall, my point still does stand. I do believe that there's going to be original content within the first few episodes. But anyway, regardless of that, it seemed to me, especially when I was streaming the event and seeing the reactions from the live streams of, you know, after the PV was shown, it seems that another announcement that we had was, in fact, drumroll please, a Bleach rock musical. Now, for those that don't particularly know, the Bleach rock musical has happened since the dawn of time of Bleach's serialization, especially within its anime format. It is a thing that has been very popular for a very long time, and of course, obviously, the last rendition, I think, was just before the manga ended, or maybe, no, it was after the manga ended, and it did its Blu-ray release. Now, I think that was its 3rd or 4th rendition. The first one wasn't really recorded, then the second one was, and then the third one was then on Blu-ray. So there was a DVD version, and then the next one after that was then a Blu-ray version, and it just upped itself in production quality throughout. And of course, there was also Kubo being a screenwriter, so there was some little bits of dialogue which foreshadowed things like Compachi and Unohana. But regardless of what, you know, people in the comment section, and I get it, we're Western, we're never gonna appreciate or see this sort of stuff, just like pretty much the Bleach exposition or exhibition, there we go, I keep saying expedition, it's exhibition, we're not gonna really experience those, so these things are not going to mean pretty much anything to us. And I get it, I get the disappointment, but you have to understand that the Bleach rock musical is extremely successful, and any profit or any success in regards to Bleach's events in general is always a dub. Just because we can't really enjoy it doesn't mean we can't enjoy the success that it gives towards the Bleach IP, because any success is good success in my eyes, right? And it really forwards the IP and the franchise further and gives more confidence into companies dabbling into the Bleach IP. There've been plenty of musicals, and it isn't something that's new or special. Hunter x Hunter, One Piece, and even quite recently, Kentucky Hitman Reborn has had a musical. So, you know, again, they do well. But no one, I don't think, has had as many musicals as Bleach has personally had. So it really goes to show its attribution to how popular it is. I'm pretty sure many of you can even look at the Blu-ray and DVD sales of those as well and be pretty impressed by them as a whole. So it makes complete perfect sense of why a Bleach rock musical is coming back. And of course, it's going to be the Ironka rock, so a bigger cast, a longer storyline, a longer length. So you know that there's going to be investment within this. So the question I posed to you guys, or what I posed on Twitter and to a few friends, is what is the alternative? And no, I don't want to talk about the Hell arc yet. I want to wait until I talk about my Bleach X experience and then talk about the Hell arc in regarding that. But I guess when you compare it to things such as what was announced at Jump Festa, such as like JJK or Chainsaw Man, or whatever else was announced at Jump Festa at the time, having a Bleach rock musical doesn't really seem to fit the bill. However, we need to look at things on a contextual level and talk about what we could get in the future, but not right now. Let's talk about first the Hell arc. Again, we haven't even touched light novel stuff. I don't think talking about the Hell arc is something we should be discussing right now. We know it's probably going to happen. You know, think of the long term for Bleach. Second of all, Bleach X just finished. Well, in a few days, it's going to be finishing as of the recording of this video, which was an extremely insane turnout. Remember that this is an expedition or exhibition that started 2 years ago. It's one of the longest art museums that's ever probably happened in anything in regarding Jump. That is huge. They even did this really cool thing where they, you know, they released a Blu-ray for the exhibition, purely because of just how popular it is. It's insane. And again, I'll talk about my experience because there's so much I want to say about that as a whole, and talk about the marketing as well as like the new content that we see there as well. So again, hit that subscribe and hear my thoughts on that. And I may or may not show pictures. I'm not quite sure. I got told off by the official Bleach account for posting them previously. But anyway, as an event, or as the event goes, I think it was a very good event. It was strong. And in regards to what else they could have announced for Bleach, I'm not quite sure what they could have announced. Again, people are asking for Burn the Witch. Again, that's a Bandai thing. They will do their own thing. This was a Bleach event purely and not Burn the Witch related. People also saying maybe we could have got a Kubo comment. I absolutely agree. I think a Kubo comment would have really been nice, but we kind of maybe have got that on Twitter a little bit. I'm not quite sure. Again, it would have been nice. People want a movie. Let's talk about a movie. One, let's get through the Thousand Blood War arc. I know you guys are very passionate and you want to get like so much content. You want to get your JJK type treatment and you want to get your Chainsaw Man type treatment. But realistically, Piro isn't MAPPA. MAPPA have taken most of the talented animators that currently exist in Japan, if not China, and even overseas as well. MAPPA is completely, I don't know why, I mean, that's a whole video in and of itself, and we can go on a tangent and talk about many different reasons to why, but to keep it short and sweet, MAPPA have taken a bunch of talent and contracted them, and yeah, so you really want them to work on a movie? No, not at all. You want a release date? Now that is absolutely very viable, and I think that is something that we should have had announced as well, but you have to see things as like, do you know what? We know it's going to happen in 2024. I'm quite happy that there is no release date for magnitudes of reasons. In fact, you know, I've been hearing things along the lines, and again, I'm not really in depth as I used to be in the previous course, but I've heard things as such as like they're really keeping the staff listing and who they've hired very secretive or very much behind closed doors. And I couldn't tell you the reason why, but I would imagine, you know, considering that a lot of web genres, will just say, that haven't been asked back, I assume that they probably got some really good talent, and I think that they kind of overestimate themselves with Core 2. And again, when it comes to Core 2, I want to make sure I do that video right on my overall thoughts, but I think they overestimated themselves with Core 2, and I think they went back to the drawing board and said, you know what, we need more time than 6 months, we need way more time than that. And I think they're really going to go for it, so we can only find out until later on. I don't want to overspeak my boundary as it goes on so far. But again, Hell Arc movie, it's not viable. And I think, you know, to ask that is asking too much. And I think you're wanting, you know, the demand is there, and that's good. I think the studio and the production committee want to know that that is something that is required. But as for now, I don't think it's doable. There's no staff. Let them focus on the Thousand Year Blood War first, and then maybe a movie. Maybe, I mean, who knows? We Cannot Always Love You, or is it? No, sorry. We Do Not Always Love You, and Safwi or Spirits of Forever With You might be movie format. We don't know. I'd like that. I'd also like a series, because series adds more and it doesn't really skip over things. So again, that would be really cool, but we will get those announcements probably towards at the end of Core 4. So, you know, again, after Shonen Jump posted a audiobook of We Do Not Always Love You, which is on the Shueisha page, you may or may not need a VPN, I'm not quite sure, but again, that was a nice little touch. Again, it was the anniversary for Jump J Book, so I don't know if it was a Bleach specific thing, but again, it was nice nonetheless, because again, paying for voice actors aren't cheap in Japan. They are classed as like A-list celebrities in terms of like Hollywood, but over here. So that's pretty impressive and important, and it does get my brain tinkling a little bit, but it would make sense. And then I think first and foremost, we should talk about a game, and I will be talking about this in a separate video in regards to my reaction on like Hunter x Hunter getting a game. All I will say is that, as we currently know, is that Kubo's acknowledged that there were talks of a game happening that weren't going to be a mobile game. So this isn't talking about Soul Resonance at all. So there's talks about a game, and I understand a lot of you want an announcement for the game. I do think it's needed, especially for console. I do think there needs to be a competitive slash casual scene for it, and I mean, I've heard things here and there about it as well, but again, that's a Bandai diff. That really is a Bandai diff. So overall, I think what we have with the Bleach Rock musical announcement, I think, is the apex or the pinnacle of what, as of this current moment in time, that we can have without affecting the studio or, you know, the voice actors, etc., etc. Because, you know, if you're going to have like a game, you're going to, you know, bother the voice actors as well. So I think this is the best solution. I would have also taken like a part two of like a Netflix Bleach live action, because I really enjoyed the first one, but with the Soul Society, maybe that would be too much, especially with like the CGI that like probably Soul Society would have. But I think that this is that middle ground, and to be honest with you, you have to remember, and I think this is the most important thing I should end off on this video, it is important that first and foremost, the Japanese audience do matter the most, and I think that's how it should be. You know, I do think we do deserve things, but again, you know, coming at Jump Festa or maybe Shueisha is probably the wrong people to come out. You know, you really do have to look at Viz in regards to bringing Bleach X overseas. Maybe Shueisha can actually do it themselves and make it global and completely cut Viz out of it. That would be fantastic. Again, I don't know the linguistics of all that, but yes, like, I think a global Bleach exhibition would do amazingly well, as well as other things. But again, is that Jump Festa announcement worthy? No, because it doesn't really affect the Japanese audience that are actually in Japan attending Jump Festa itself, which is for a Japanese audience because of the country that it's based in. So again, what appeals to the Japanese audience? And they like their musicals, and if it does successfully, then all for it. But tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. What would you have liked as a substitution? What of you would have liked to kind of replace Bleach X? And are you happy with the Bleach Rock musical? Do you think that this is a good idea? Or was there any alternatives that could have gone, that isn't a game, that isn't Hell Arc, or that isn't Burn the Witch? Think outside the box. What could have we have had? What, another pachinko machine? Another amusement park ride? You know, I mean, we have trading cards. That's for like, what was it called? Union Battle something, something Union. Jump you, no, it's not. It's something Union, there's a card game. And that's actually getting an international release, which is going to be really cool. So hopefully, I mean, I can pick some up now, but I'd like to pick those up as well. But regardless of what do you think can be announced that other series may or may not have gotten that you can use as a point of reference? But with that being said, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers out. You guys, of course, have this fine day, Debbie Hansen, and as always, people, peace out.